Well, that was a unique viewing experience. Welcome to the Time Treadmill. I'm Ron, and these are my sweaty thoughts about Doctor Who. First off, some housekeeping before I get to Doctor Who. I just want to acknowledge I took off 3 days over Christmas as a present to myself, just so I didn't have to not only stress about getting on the treadmill or the stupid elliptical for right now, but also not stress about editing and publishing videos for a couple of days. It was a very nice break, and then I got right back to it. But there entered the second problem. My main computer has been having huge stability issues for a couple of weeks now, and on top of that, my home server has been out of commission for a couple of months now. So I wound up spending a good chunk of the last couple of days first getting my home server situation back up and running so I have a good place for backups, and then next trying to troubleshoot my own system, which turned out to be bad memory, but it took quite a bit of trial and error and troubleshooting and pulling out all of the memory sticks and running diagnostics on each one individually before I finally identified the problem. Good news is I've found the absolutely, definitely bad memory stick, replaced it. I was able to run a stress test on my system for over 14 hours with no errors whatsoever, and I'm comfortable that I'm up and running again. So odds are I'm publishing not only this, but the previous 2 days on the treadmill, or stupid elliptical, all on the same day if I get them all edited today, and then I'll be caught back up. And there endeth the housekeeping. Enlightenment. Enlightenment is unique among Doctor Who stories. Certainly at the time it was aired, it was the first story to be both written and directed by women. And in fact, that has only happened one other time, just in the last season with the 13th Doctor. So on that count, it's an interesting story. Doubly interesting is that the DVD release of this story includes a special edition second disc that presents the entire story as a single movie-length film. And it's not just that they spliced together all four parts into one runtime. Director Fiona Cumming actually came back to the material 30 years later, went through the whole thing, did a complete re-edit to put it all together into a 75-minute feature-length film. And that includes newer CGI special effects to do the story justice where it needed it. And I have to tell you, it works fantastically. I definitely enjoyed watching this as a single film, although being as it took over 75 minutes to get through, it's the longest I've ever been on the elliptical and the longest continuous on any of the time treadmill stuff for quite some time. But that being said, I'm going to hit that again the day after tomorrow when I get to the Five Doctors 20th anniversary special. So a good practice workout for what I'm going to hit in just a couple of days. But getting back to Enlightenment, it's the conclusion to the Black Guardian trilogy, and realistically the anchor story that the previous two stories were retrofit into to create the trilogy. As a matter of fact, when the story was originally written, it was not the Black and White Guardians at the end of the story, it was the Enlighteners, and originally the story was called Enlighteners. But then when it was decided that everything in this season would be villains from previous stories, the Black and White Guardian were brought in, and the whole thing was retrofit. The story was retitled Enlightenment, which was the name of the prize to be won in this interstellar yacht race. And then the Black Guardian's plot with Turlough to kill the Doctor was retrofitted back to the previous two stories. So on that count, it's really interesting to see the behind-the-scene machinations on how all of this was pieced together. As a standalone story, it's really, really interesting. This story introduces the notion of Eternals, of a race of people who do not live or die. They exist forever. But because they are eternal, they really lack any of the creativity or spontaneity that humans or ephemerals have. And so the entire basis of this story is a yacht race through space using crews of kidnapped humans from different time periods in order to man the ships and win the great prize. In that sense, it's very, very much like the War Games, which also used humans, pick from different time zones to pit against each other. But at the crux of it, this is again a story that could only really have happened in the Fifth Doctor era. There's certainly a small amount of action, but really the core of the story is entirely philosophical. It comes down to a moment of choice, first for the Doctor and then for Turlough, on whether to accept this reward of enlightenment or to pass on it. And it really marks as the moment that Turlough fully becomes a true traveling companion of the Doctor and is no longer conflicted and plotting against him. And the fact is, he never wanted to kill the Doctor in the first place. He was twisted into this bargain against his will, and frankly was a poor choice by the Black Guardian. I mean, yes, he's greedy and devious and plotting, but he's not a murderer. So, overall, big thumbs up to this story. This really should count as the season finale. There's one more two-parter tomorrow that is, well, unique in its own right, and I'll get there tomorrow. But this truly wraps up the main story arc of this entire season. And I would say if you have the opportunity to watch this in its film form, this one really is worth it. It's not just an omnibus edition like other ones that have been done. It really is carefully crafted and re-edited to work as a feature film. And major props to the director for what she achieved with it. Thoroughly enjoyed it. And on that count, I'm going to call this a day. I will see you tomorrow for The King's Demons and the android companion that wasn't.